Uncle Clint.
That was my favorite nephew.
Okay.
Good. Matthew, I think it's time that you and I had a little talk.
About what?
Your future.
Yeah. Hey. I just got off the phone. Local police in Tahiti just took Eli Clark into custody.
Oh, that's great news.
Thank you for your help with all the authorities there.
I'm just glad that maniac's finally caught.
Well, what about my future?
Something your Grandpa Asa said. It's been weighing on my mind lately.
Why, what'd Grandpa say?
Asa said someday he wanted you to run Buchanan Enterprises.
Wow.
You seem surprised.
I remember him saying something like that to me when I was younger, but I never thought he was serious.
Oh, Asa was always dead serious when it came to business. No, Matthew, he saw something in you, a certain quality that he thought would develop, and I think it has. In fact, I think you're the only Buchanan left that has the stones to do this job, besides me, of course.
And what about David?
He can't even manage to make it to his own wedding, let alone run a billion-dollar multinational conglomerate.
You think I can?
Oh, not yet, no, but I think you already have the one thing that you need the most.
What's that?
Killer instinct.
Does Kelly know that Eli's behind bars?
She and Rex were in my office when I found out.
And she has to be relieved.
Yeah, you could say that.
Mother's killer, caught, finally. Blair's safe.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about the last part. Well, I...
You really think I have a killer instinct?
It's a Buchanan family trait. Asa had it in spades, and I think I've proven myself in that department as well.
You mean like when you brought the shotgun to my parents' wedding and threatened to shoot my brother?
There are better examples, but that'll do. And I'm not going to lie to you here. There's nothing I would have enjoyed more than putting some buckshot in the backside of David Vickers. And I'm sorry, because I know how you feel about David.
It's okay. I know you have your own reasons not to like him.
This goes way beyond not liking him. David destroyed my marriage to Kimberly, and the only reason I backed off that day in church was I didn't want to ruin your parents' wedding. But it's all right, because someday I'm going to find a way to pay David back. Of course, you know all about payback, don't you?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about what you did to Nate Salinger.
What are you talking about? I didn't do anything to Nate.
You can drop the innocent act, Matthew, because I know that you told that bounty hunter that Nate had the money that he was looking for. Now, you could have kept your mouth shut, but Nate had stolen your girlfriend, so you got him back good, didn't you?
How do you know all this?
I make it my business to know.
Are you going to tell my dad?
Why wouldn't Blair be safe if Eli's caught?
I have to speak to her. They wouldn't put her on the phone. They wouldn't even verify she was there. No one would give me a straight answer.
This is the officer in charge?
No one seemed to know where the officer in charge was. And they sort of gave me the bum rush on the phone and hung up.
You think Eli did something to Blair before he was caught?
All I know is I'd feel a hell of a lot better if we were the ones who had Eli in custody.
Don't worry. I won't be telling your pa what you did to Nate.
You won't?
No. After all, kid had it coming.
Yeah, he did, but I don't think my dad would see it that way.
Probably not, no, because Bo didn't inherit that killer instinct from Asa like you and I did. Don't you get me wrong now, though. I admire my little brother's dedication to the law, but Bo and I, we see the world very, very differently.
How?
Well, we both believe in justice, but Bo believes in the system, whereas I believe in an eye for an eye. And I think you believe that, too. Matthew, you could really go a long way if you make the right choices.
What are those?
Well, like I said, Ace and I both thought that eventually you should be the next CEO. And there's not a reason in the world that your training can't start right now, so long as you're interested.
But I'm just a junior in high school. I haven't really decided what I'm going to do with my life.
Well, sometimes life decides what it wants to do with you. And this is one of those times. All right? Now, here's the plan, so listen up. I want you to start working part-time at BE from the bottom up, because you're going to learn this business from the ground up. You understand?
What about school?
Well, it's not a problem, because I'm talking about working hours after school and maybe a Saturday here and there. So what do you say?
It's not that I don't want to, but...
But?
I just don't think my parents are going to go for it. You know, school comes first.
That's fine. Yeah, but I can guarantee you, you will learn more in 1 week at BE than you'll learn all year at school. Starting with how to make sure no woman ever hurts you again.
Telling me that you want to go to Tahiti and bring Clark back yourself?
Yeah, I do. I know it's a lot to ask. It's an expensive trip.
Oh, sure is. But you know, that guy's been jerking us around, this department, for months now. And I don't intend to let him get away with it. So I think the first thing that we have to do is make sure that Eli is locked up in a Landview jail cell ASAP.
You saying what I think you're saying?
Yeah. You go get the bastard. I'll call the Justice Department, get the extradition rolling. You get to the airport.
Thanks, Bo. I owe you one.
Yeah, well, just be careful.
Absolutely. Yes.
Yeah.
Commissioner?
Nate, what can I do for you?
I didn't mean to interrupt. I was just looking for my mom. I thought she was working.
Well, yeah, she, you just missed her. She stepped out for a second.
Oh, okay. I'll just catch up to her later then.
No, 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 no. Hey, come. Hold on.
Sir?
How you doing?
I have two older brothers my mom didn't tell me about. And the good news is only one of them hates my guts. Other than that, I'm fine.
You know, I don't know how much she's explained to you, but I think you do need to understand that your mom was in a real tough spot.
Yeah. Thank you for giving her this job. It really saved our lives.
I was happy to help.
What the hell are you doing here?
I was looking for my mother.
Really? What'd you get busted for?
Not Matthew. Nate's mom is my new assistant.
She's what? How could you hire his mom after what he did to me?
I have to get to work.
You didn't really hire his mom, did you?
Yes, I did.
After he stole my girlfriend.
Matthew, hiring Nate's mom has nothing to do with you. I needed a new assistant. She needed a job, and she is very qualified.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure she's very qualified. You probably had 100 people that wanted to be your assistant. Go hire one of them.
I know how angry you are at Nate.
Angry? I am more than angry with Nate, Dad. Danny wasn't just my girlfriend. She was more than that. She was there when I busted out of Warwick and flew to Seattle to get my surgery. She was there when I took my first steps.
I know.
And now we don't even talk, and it's all because of that son of a bitch.
Matthew, I know how bad you feel.
Then fire her and get them out of our lives.
No, I'm not going to do that.
Why not?
Because whatever happened between you and Nate, his mother still has a right to work.
Okay, so this right to work, does that apply to everyone?
Of course it does.
Great, then you won't have any problem with me going to work with Uncle Clint, will you?